Esiste un club i cui membri sono destinati a fare grandi cose.
It's definitely fun to play that sort of that darker character. And it makes you come away feeling slightly dirty because Lona did this great thing which we didn't necessarily realize was happening at the time. Lona Scherfig being the director, that she really encouraged us to fall in love with her character. She tricked us into sort of to really going to that place and not judging them. She made us feel that we didn't have to judge them. And it felt like they were really judged in the edit rather than on the day, which was great.
And also, it's you know, as an actor, I think, yeah, you can't judge a character, but also you have to ask yourself questions, and you really have to be honest. Am I guilty of some of these things? Maybe not to such an extent, but on a more smaller level, am I guilty of these thoughts or feeling that I'm better than someone else? You have to really be honest and ask yourself these questions, which is a good thing, I think.
I think for me it was just really exciting to portray a character that, or to be able to show a different side of my personality. I mean, I think everyone holds a bit of darkness within them and they show it in different ways, and I don't think I do tend to show it very often, so it was my opportunity to kind of, I don't know, let all the skeletons out of the closet.
Benvenuto nel Riot Club.
Il Riot Club?
Da centinaia di anni ammette solo i migliori.
Mi scusi, non può passare di là.
Le somiglia molto, mi dispiace tanto.
Siamo l'università più importante del mondo. E possiamo fare quello che ci pare. Quando ci pare. E con chi ci pare.
If you look at the sort of opposite end of the spectrum, you know, if this was 10... you know, young kids who are in a gang from a very, very poor upbringing, and they'd probably all go to prison and stay in prison for attempted murder. But the fact is, one of them goes down, but actually is kind of, you know, hailed for it. It's ridiculous, but it's basically an insight into how the world is now.
That's the thing. There's no Disney happy ending to this film. It's not positive and upbeat, and, you know, it's realistic.
Everywhere you look, yeah.
Uscite dal mio locale.
Oops.
Ho bisogno di te. Un'ambulanza, per favore. È successa una cosa.
Abbiamo fatto un errore di calcolo.
Quelli come noi non sbagliano.
I think, unless you have, I think. People do. Everyone, everywhere gets carried away with power. I think that's the scary thing about it. I think what's needed is, you know, a great support network, and with us people kind of keeping you grounded. You know, in a weird way, we have some power because people are inspired by our careers or whatever it might be as actors, and we have a platform to kind of speak our feelings. But we're sort of lucky enough to have a great sort of family or group of friends who are able to kind of keep us grounded and not let the power go to our heads and get lost in ourselves and start acting like divas and requesting fireplaces in my, you know, trailer or whatever. You can see why people get carried away, but like, it's not something I agree with.
I think it's less about age and more about intelligence. Yeah, and about it doesn't matter what age you are. It's not about getting power too young. It's how you use it, and how educated you are, and not necessarily educated like gone to a great school. I mean, just with life, educated in life, yeah, and experience, and how you use it, and the responsibility of it.
Sono stufo marcio della gente povera.
A noi.
Io sono innocente.
Appartieni al club, ok? Siamo tutti innocenti.